been hacked. There are such allegations. So how do you see into this, and what is the present condition of education in the state of Tripura?
Look, on the 16th of this month, few days back, the education minister of Tripura state leaked a paper telling that this is a letter sent by Tripura BJP state in charge to HRD minister Shri Javadekar, and in that I have mentioned that all these 13,000 jobs which are created by this government are fraud and they should be cancelled. It was a totally false allegation, and the very first question arose: whatever mail was sent to Mr. Javadekar, in that there was a representation that what is the stand taken by ruling CPM government regarding 10,323 jobs which were cancelled by Supreme Court. So what is the status, what are the steps taken by CPM party? That was written in a draft and that representation was mailed from my email ID. So the very first question raised by me was, where it is written in that representation that you cancel all these appointments? Second thing, it was a personal mail, private mail, which was sent to Prakash Javadekar ji, to a minister, union minister, cabinet minister, by a BJP state in charge. From where you got this printout of that mail? It means that you have stolen this mail either by hacking my account or by taking out this paper from government office. During that period, he never clarified that from where he has got that paper. And that is why my allegation was, it was a crime committed by education minister, and it is very shameful that an education minister commits such type of crime. Then what type of generation they want in Tripura? When I threatened about going for criminal case, then day before yesterday again education minister came out with a document telling that no, this was not hacked or this was not stolen, but the same paper was sent by education ministers, this ministry, human resources development ministry, to state government asking for clarification. And what clarification? Whatever you have done regarding these jobs, kindly respond today itself, because it is a sensitive issue whether these jobs you have created and whatever qualifications you are asking for, are they proper under the Right to Education Act? This clarification was demanded by central government, where they have done nothing wrong. And I sent the mail on 25th May. Central government sent them mail on 1st June and they asked them to send reply on the same day, but they did not. They sent the mail on 7th June and telling that the situation of Tripura is very pathetic, education system is very pathetic, we don't get the quality of teachers over here, and that is why we have made some adjustments and all. It means that this education minister and education department of Tripura, they admit that we are useless people, we are hopeless people, and we are not able to provide education at par in our state. And in fact, in 17 years, there was no recruitment of any teacher in this state. 17 years.
Primary
teacher was not recruited in Tripura. How it can happen in any of the state of our country? But it happens under an incompetent chief minister, Manik Sarkar's regime in Tripura. they want that people should not study, they should not learn, they should stay illiterate, so that they will be always dependent on party and their concept of party society will come true. And that is what happening in Tripura. So I condemn in very strong words the deeds of this education minister. And finally, there is nothing that I have demanded that jobs should be cancelled. Rather, Bharatiya Janata Party, Tripura Pradesh, State President Biplab Deb and myself, time and again we warn this government that now at least don't do any fraud to people just because of political benefit, misguiding them that yes, now Supreme Court has cancelled your jobs, don't worry, we are providing your jobs, we are returning your jobs, and that is why they are creating a show that your jobs will be returned because elections are coming. They are worried about more than 2 lakh votes of this more than 10,000 families and their relatives. And that is why it is very shameful part of this state government, and I condemn it very strongly.
Sir, a report is pouring in that a television journalist, most probably this is the first time, he has been murdered in this political turbulence particularly. So what is your opinion?
See, thousands of people are murdered in CPM rule. There is no justice to people. This today's incidents, I am very shocked, and it is very disturbing that a journalist is killed where the law and order was in the hands of CPM government. And recently we saw many of the representations and morchas and all about a murder of journalist in Karnataka, and it is very shameful that in Tripura, where a young journalist who went for covering the riots between CPM and other party, local party, and just now I heard, I don't know who killed that journalist, who is behind this killing, but it is very shameful, and I am feeling so sorry about this, and I want whoever have killed this journalist, they should be booked immediately, and they should be punished very strongly, and immediately investigation should take place, and obviously our journalist will demand, but judicial inquiry should take place. We don't have faith in this government, so there should be a judicial inquiry conducted about the killing of a young journalist in Tripura.
Chief Minister Manik Sarkar, who also holds the post as the Home Minister, do you think he is incompetent? Because the police has, in everywhere there are complaints. Even yesterday so many vehicles were burned. Earlier also there has been such riot in this capital city Agartala. But there has been investigation, there has been judicial, but nothing result has come out. How do you see into it? It is...
See, that is why always I call Manik Sarkar as a Nikamma Mukhyamantri. Because even when he became chief minister and the choice of all MLAs for chief ministerial candidate was Bimal Sinha, when Manik Sarkar got his name as chief minister from Politburo, then Bimal Sinha, most coveted candidate for chief minister in this state, was killed within a month, and till date he has not got the justice. When a minister of Manik Sarkar's government was killed and he has not got justice, 4 MLAs in this state, out of 4 MLAs, Anand Ruwaza was MLA of CPM, he was killed, and it is suspected that he was killed by a person now who is presently MLA of that constituency. Not only he was killed, then the potential candidate was his son, so his son was also killed. And there is no justice to Ruwaza father and son murders. More than 1,000 people were killed, and that is why Chief Justice Deepak Gupta, when he left the state in his final talk given in front of journalists or somewhere, he said that there is no law and order in this state. Even charge sheet, the police fails to file the charge sheet because police is working as B team of local CPM party. So this grave situation of law and order will only change when BJP will come to power in this state.
Thank you. Asok ji,